The storefront is modeled after the ones in the Kariakoo district in Dar es Salaam. You can get anything you want. Tires, a passport, stereos, phones, t-shirts, everything. And if that person isn't directly selling the thing that you need, if you ask them, they can get that for you. I chose Leo na Kesho as a title because the title translates to today and tomorrow. The point of the piece is to think about the current relationship of people on the continent and specifically in Tanzania. An important thing to consider when it comes to the inspiration for this particular work is the moment in which it came into the world, and that was in 2020, after the murder of George Floyd and the cultural uprisings and reckoning that occurred. A lot of institutions decided that they were gonna sort of make shifts. I was invited to be an Osher Fellow that year. And I had a sense that it was tied into this sort of cultural moment. I was given a virtual tour of the museum, and one of the last things we did was walk through African Hall. It reminded me of all the other natural history museums that I'd been a part of. Dioramas, as an art form and as a craft, the levels of artistry are really amazing, but it's also combined with this sort of problematic extractive history, and also its storytelling from an external vantage point. They've presented caricatures of people in their living environments. The way that story is presented, it leaves you the impression that as people became modern, they left. And there's a billion modern people there in Africa right now. There are parts of the piece that are deeply personal to me and are like centered around my own parents. There was a bicycle that my father used to own, and I couldn't imagine building this piece without a bike that felt like his bike. I've lived the early part of my life in East Africa, and then I moved to the United States when I was 8. There was something in me that wanted to settle into that connection with my home and with my ancestry and my people in East Africa and in Tanzania specifically. When I think about science and art, they're both ways of getting to know how the world works. You build tools, you ask questions, you engage with phenomena, and then you respond to the result. It's about taking in the world, running it through our particular lens, and then putting something into the world that generates questions, that helps you understand the world a little bit better.